Welcome to my first tutorial about GIMP and pixel art. This first video will be about the configuration, the setup, and the basics of GIMP. If you struggle with GIMP or if you don't like GIMP, maybe you like minimal knowledge about the software, that will make your life easier later. And, I recommend you follow this first tutorial if you are not a pro with GIMP. So, first of all, what you need is to have a picture. So I will create this one. You can set the size here, and here we are. You can see the background is already white because this is the default background color, second color here. So you don't need the first layer, it is just created by GIMP. Okay, now if you don't have this setup, if you don't see the toolbars on the side in the same window, you can click on Window, Single Window Mode, and you will have the same interface than me. Then go in Edit, Preferences, and I highly recommend doing two things. First of all, in Interface, you should see Use Dynamic Keyboard Shortcuts. This is a great feature, I highly recommend checking this one. Second thing is going into Toolbox and disable Use Tool Groups, because this will hide some tools behind other tools, and even if you know GIMP, you will spend time to just find the right tools, so I highly recommend unchecking this one. Okay, now we can start. Okay, you see here your current picture. You can have a few. And there are like tabs in a browser for every picture. You have the toolbox and the settings of each tool. You have the layers. You can add some layers and suppress them just by clicking the button. And you have, of course, your picture. It will be enough to start. You don't really need to check everything to be able to use GIMP. Okay, so now there are some things you have to know if you want to use GIMP correctly. First of all, the transparency. When you create a new layer, it looks like this. I haven't checked this one. You have transparency everywhere. There is no background color. And this is good for addition. Do multiple layers when on top of the others. But on the basic background layer, you have a basic color, and if you use the eraser tool, it does nothing because this layer has no transparency. So you can't remove by this unless you right click and add alpha channel. Alpha channel is the channel of transparency. So if you don't have alpha channel, you can't have transparency. But as soon as you click and add the alpha channel, now you can remove colors and have a transparent background or an half transparent. That's the same. So make sure if you can't remove something to have an alpha channel. This is not only for this layer, it can be the same with other layers if you create them without an alpha channel. Okay, we don't need the background layer and we will start to something. I will click on the pencil tool. You have the pen brush tool, but for pixel art you will only use pencil tool. The difference between the two is there is no aliasing, anti-aliasing on this one. So if I use the pen brush tool, I have something like this, and with the pencil I have something like this. So for pixel art you can't use the first one. Now, another thing you have to know is the layers. If you create something like this on this layer and use this tool to move the layer, you will notice the shape of the layer is following what you are moving. It's because this is the shape and size of the layer. So if you try to draw outside of the layer, you can't. This can be fixed pretty easily. You just need to have the layer selected, go into layer, and do layer to image size, for example. And this will allow you to make things to paint everywhere. This is pretty important. Also, you have pretty much the same thing with selection. If you do a selection like this, I will use a shortcut to show my selection. If you use your brush, you paint only what is selected. So that means if one day you are trying to paint and nothing happens, it can be for this reason, because you are outside of the selection, or it can be because the opacity is set to zero. So make sure you don't have this if you struggle with writing things. You also have the layer hidden that can do the same, you can't see what you are doing, and you can't paint on a hidden layer. But this is great because this selection is already an amazing tool. For example, if you do something like a shape, let's say something like this, you can right click and do alpha to selection. So if you follow the instructions, you know alpha is the transparency. So if you click on this, selection will be the transparency of the channel. And this is really, really a useful tool. For example, if you want to draw text, like something like this, you can then right-click alpha to selection, create a new layer. You can do shift-click to create directly a new layer without having the pop-up. And on this layer selected, you can now use this tool to put black, for example. New layer, we'll hide this one, undo black here. So now you remove the selection, you can select this tool and click elsewhere, and you can move it with this tool a little to make a shadow, for example. It is already really useful, but you can go ahead and do something else. Alpha to selection again, create a new layer, select another color, select a brush, a pencil for example, and with this color and a smaller side, you can add color like this. So this is really easy to do some shadow things. For example, again, you right click on the test alpha to selection and put everything with this color, and then you select white, reduce the size, do lighting like this to make your text easier to read and have a nice effect, like a metallic effect. This is really simple. We will do much more interesting in a later video, but that's all for the basics. So thanks for following, and be sure to check the next one, where will be plenty of more interesting things about pixel art. Bye bye.